Then, on this lesson, we'll be focusing on the sin rule, which will be for grade 11s and also grade 12s. We know from grade 10 that if we are given an angle, this is called an angle alpha, for example. If I'm given that angle there, the side that will be opposite to my angle, we call that the opposite side. And then this side that will be formed there is the between side. And then this call this one there, adjacent side, based on what we know in grade 10. So the sin rule in grade 10, we know that sin will be opposite over hypotenuse based on SOHCAHTOA. So remember, this will apply if I'm having a right angle triangle. So now, if we're given a triangle like this, for example, this is no longer a right angle triangle. So we can't use the same sin rule from grade 10. Now we will use this formula for the sin rule. So this is the formula for sin rule, which you will use if you're given a triangle which is not right angle triangle. So now, whenever you're given these three different angles, remember we've got angle A here, we've got angle B there, and angle C. Also, we know about triangles that the sum of triangles must add up to 180. Now, the side that is opposite angle A here will represent by small letter A. The side that is opposite angle B will represent by small letter B. The side that is opposite angle C will be small letter C. So that's how the formula comes about. A is the small letter A there, small letter B, and small letter C. So you equate each. But mostly, we tend to equate only two. You can equate A over sine A with a B over sine B, or you can equate A over sine A with C over sine C, or you can equate B also with C, depending on the given information. Let's just do a quick example to show you guys how this will look like in the exam. Let's say we're given a triangle like this. So on this triangle, we're given angle B and also angle C. Also, we're given two sides, which is side AB and also side AC. Another thing that you must always remember, for the sin rule to apply, you must have at least two angles and one side, or you can have two sides and one angle. If you can just have one angle and two sides, you can apply the sin rule. Also, if you're given two angles and one side, also you can apply the sin rule. So here we're given a lot of information which will allow us to solve what they want us to find. So on the first question here, they're asking us to find angle A. Angle A is this guy here. So we know about triangles. The sum of a triangle must add up to 180. Angle B and angle C, they're given to us already. And then we know that angle A and plus angle B plus angle C, all three angles in a triangles, when you add them, they must end up to 180 degrees. That is the sum of a triangle now. So now we're given two of them. So meaning to find angle A, as they're asking us to find, they're not to find angle A. So to find angle A, we know angle A will be 180 minus the other two angles now. So it'll be 180 minus, in bracket, just put in bracket, angle B, we know it's given to us as 60, and then plus your angle C, which is given to us as 40. So basically, this will be 180 minus 100. So meaning angle A will be 80 degrees now. So angle A is 80 degrees. So just go there and put the value as it is. So angle A is 80 degrees for the first answer there. That's fine there. So now you just need to go there and now check the second question. They're asking us to find length BC, this length here. So we know that that length there will be given as small letter A, because that is opposite angle A, né? So meaning here it's opposite C, meaning to be small letter C there, then opposite angle B with this one as small letter B. So now we need to go and find length of BC. In other words, we need to go and find small letter A now. So you can decide which one to use. You can equate A and B, or you can equate A and C based on the given information. So we want to find small letter A here. We have angle A already, so that's fine. So we can use that. So the aim is to find A. So you must have this one there because we need to find it. And we already know that angle A we just found now is 80 degrees. So it will be sine angle A, that is 80. Then you equate now. Now you must decide which one I'm going to use. Either use B or C. So if we decide to use B, we know that small type B is given to us as 4 there. If we use B, that will be 4 there. Then everything will be over sine. Angle B, we know it's what? Given to us as 60 degrees. So that will be your two solutions. Remember, you must only use two. You can equate three at the same time. Decide to use two. You can either equate A with C or A with B, depending on the given information. But here, I'm just equating A and B together. I'm only focusing on these two to solve for the missing side, which is matter A. From there onwards, we can just do our lovely cost multiplication. This will multiply this one there, and then this one will multiply that one there. So this will just simplify and come back as it will be A small tie A sine 60 being equals to 4 sine 8 sine 60 here. Yeah. Sine 60 being equals to 4 sine 80 being equals to 4 sine 80. 4 sine 80 there. And then you divide everything because they need to find small tie A. So you divide everything by sine 60 because the aim is to find small tie A, and then also divide this by sine 60. So meaning small tie A will be this two will cancel now, and then meaning my small tie A will be 4 sine 80 divided by sine 60. So it will be 4 sine 80 4 sine 80, just quickly get that one. So it'll be 4 sine 80 divided by sine 60. So I got a value of small tie A here, the value of 4.55. I got 4.55 as small tie A. So my answer that I got is 4.55. So that is my answer that I got as 4.55. So that will be all for sine rule. And then please check our playlist because we're going to also have lessons about cosine rule and also area rule and also some exam questions. Thank you very much. And I hope this was also helpful. And please comment if you have good questions. And also like and share. Don't forget also to subscribe, and yeah, thank you very much. See you on the next lesson.